Regents Exam, Algebra 1, August 2016, Problem Number 36. Janice is asked to solve 0 equals 64x squared plus 16x minus 3. She begins the problem by writing the following steps. Use Janice's procedure to solve the equation for x. Explain the method Janice used to solve the quadratic equation. In this problem, we have a student's initial steps towards solving a quadratic equation. We need to use the student's procedure and solve the equation for x. We also need to explain the student's method for solving the quadratic equation. Let's first analyze the student's method before we decide to use it to solve the quadratic equation. In line 1, the quadratic equation is copied. In line 2, a coefficient and the variable x is replaced with the variable b. And in line 3, the new quadratic equation in terms of the variable b is factored. The next step would be to use the zero product property and set each factor equal to 0. In this case, we set the quantity b plus 3 equal to 0 and the quantity b minus 1 equal to 0. We then solve for b in both of these linear equations. Doing that, we obtain the following. Notice that the problem is asking us to solve for x and not b. We need to replace the variable b with an expression in terms of x. By comparing the equations of line 1 and line 2, we can determine the variable expression for b. Notice that the linear term in both equations from line 1 and line 2 must equal to each other. The quadratic terms should also equal to each other. Equating the linear terms with one another and solving for b, we obtain b is equal to 8x. We can now substitute this expression for b into both linear equations as follows. Finally, we can go ahead and solve for x. Doing that, we obtain x equals negative 3 over 8 and positive 1 over 8 for the solutions of the quadratic equation. Next, we need to explain the student's method for solving this quadratic equation. The student essentially substituted b for 8x in both the quadratic term and linear term of the equation. Notice that 64x squared can be written as the quantity 8x squared. When b is substituted for 8x, we obtain b squared. Likewise, the linear term 8x gets replaced with b. By carrying out these substitutions, the quadratic equation is rewritten into a much simpler form, allowing the student to factor the quadratic equation in terms of the variable b. Once factored, the student then solved for x by substituting back the value of b with 8x, which can then be solved to obtain the solutions to the quadratic equation. So this is our final answer.